What's up, guys? You are just three lessons from completing my course. How does it feel, huh? So this time we will be creating the reservation from the scratch. We will be doing a full step-by-step creation process. And in the first video of this two video series, we will focus only on what we see when we open the reservation screen. So we won't be focusing on these additional tabs, we won't be discussing those buttons. We will focus only on the basic, straightforward reservation creation process, okay? And the next lesson will be focused on the remaining tabs. Okay, so let's go. The reservation window has been designed in such a way that you should go from the upper left corner to the bottom, and then from the upper right corner to the bottom, to successfully create the whole reservation and fill in all the data required. So when you look in the upper left corner, first of all, we have the room groups, which we have created in the previous lessons. So I won't be messing up because I already have selected my dream room. So we have a double room group, and here is the quality of life feature for you. If you select this option, you can see the available rooms and also the occupied rooms that belong to this room group. So you can make sure that no overbooking happens. Also, if I try to select an occupied room and save the reservation, KWHotel will tell me that this room is already occupied, okay? And I cannot make a reservation in it. So I'm leaving room number 7. Now, I will stress it up once again. You should definitely fill in your inventory for every room, for every room group. And the same applies to room descriptions, because this is the data that should help your receptionist when tackling the guest calls or guest inquiries and so on. Okay, this is meant to speed up your work, not to intrude your work. Next, we have the reservation dates. So here we pick the check-in date and the checkout date. And if you want, you can also use this days button. If I, for example, write 5, it will extend by 2 additional days. And what's important is that in the free version, I will remind you that there's only a single user, okay? There's only an admin user. So any person that accesses your KWHotel free calendar can open it and can make any amendments they want. And if you have a standard or pro version, this is where you can create multiple user accounts and where you can give different privileges to these accounts, which means that if I am a junior receptionist, for instance, and I open this reservation calendar, I am not able to modify the majority of stuff, okay? So this is your way to control the work of your reception. Also, you can control who did the specific action in the reservation screen and in other parts of the program, and simply gives you maximum control and maximum security over your cash flow, okay? Going forward, so now we have to write the customer name. If this is, for example, a person who already exists in the database, such as our retired Mariusz, if you click this person will be automatically loaded to the reservation. And if you don't see this hint, let's, for example, make Janine Smith, okay? If you have Janine Smith, I'm not creative with the names, sorry. If you have Janine Smith and there is no hint, this means this is a brand new person. So I will be making a reservation for Janine Smith. And please note that this is a reservation for 2 adults. So if I want to specify what those 2 people are, I should also create another customer. So we should be writing Janine Smith. And I will also save this reservation just for a second, because we can always return to what we saved. And now I go back. And here I can click the Add Customer button. And I can create another person, let's say Maria Carrier. Really not creative. Also, when you write a person, KWHotel searches if such person exists in the database and if she has any reservation history. So now we save this person, and you can see that two people are labeled in this reservation. And who will be displayed in the reservation calendar? Well, basically the person you select here. So if I select Maria Carrier and I click Save, Maria Carrier will be displayed as the owner of this reservation, let's say. Let's switch to Janine Smith. And now let's explain the difference between the Add Customer and Edit Customer options, because these are very, very vital information for you to have. So if you add a customer, you are adding a brand new entry to your database. So if I add, let's say, if I added Maria Carrier, this is a person completely new to the database. But if I click the Edit Customer button and I make any arrangements to Janine Smith's account, this will work retroactively, which means this will also affect the past reservations, the past documents, and so on. So the rule of thumb here is that you shouldn't really be using the Edit Customer option if you have already issued any document or if you don't want to mess up your past reservations. In this case, you should be adding a new customer so that it doesn't mess up. Of course, if you haven't issued any fiscal documents, you have just created this person and you simply made a typo or any other thing like that, you can easily edit customer and forget about the problem, okay? And removing customer basically removes him from the database, so nothing to write home about. Let me just improve my microphone, sorry, tech issues, equipment issues. Okay, below we have the comments section. So if we write something here, for example, customer requested airport pickup request. If you remember when we did some configuration tricks in previous videos, I showed you a way to globally display all comments from reservation. And if you don't want this to happen, you want to specify which reservation should have comments displayed on the calendar, you can click this exclamation mark. If I select it, and I save the reservation, let me just show you, the comments will be shown here, okay? And why is it shown twice, you may ask? Because I have this global option enabled, and I also have the exclamation mark enabled, which simply acts like a duplication, okay? So make sure that you select either this or that option. Let me just verify. As you can see, I was right. Now, if you would like to include more data than just these few lines, you also have this message box, which reminds me of a messenger box. If you click it here, you can write more information. It's just a Word document, you may say. And below you have this green bell icon, which goes for reminders system. And in the free version, you are not able to use the reminder system. And if you have a standard or pro version, if you set up a reminder, this means that whatever you have written here will be displayed to a person or a group of people or to everyone that logs into your KWHotel. So as I said, you can have multiple accounts with multiple privileges. And also for these people, you can associate multiple reminders. And reminders are created not only for per reservation basis, but they can also be created as a global reminders. So if we ever create a course for standard or pro version, I will probably show it there, but it's also available in our help center on kwhotel.com if you want to learn more about the reminders. And now we have this left part is over. Now we can move on to the right. So on the right, we have three room settlement options. So as I stressed before, I don't recommend you using the room rate per night or room or rate per person per night, because these two don't give you as much diversification, don't give you as much options as the rate plans give you. And rate plans are simply more effective way to boost your income, increase your revenue, And as I mentioned before, Julia Armatis, my good colleague, will create a course where she will teach you all the necessary information to also use these rate plans to their greatest potential, okay, and bring you more revenue then. But if you're still inclined to use the very, very basic way to set up rates and you want to use these two, you can do it. I'll show you how to do it. So we save the reservation. We go to the rooms section. Let's just wait for it to save. Okay. And now you go to room groups. You double click the room group you want to edit the prices for. And then below you have a very similar option to what you have seen in the rate plans, but you can write your rates here. And this is a rate for infinite amount of time, okay? So that's why rate plans are much more powerful, because you can have those low and high seasons, you can mark any events and so on. This is what you cannot do with a simple rates like that. Let's get back to our reservation. And now, below we have a summary of any accommodations, meals, and extras we have done. So about the meals, if you click here, you will see a message that this feature is not available in the free version. But if you have a standard or pro version, you can manage your restaurant or canteen directly from KW Hotel. And also, if you think about extras, you have these products. And this feature is available for KW Hotel Free, but we will not discuss it now. It will be discussed in the second part of this tutorial, okay? In the next video. So these extras that I put here in the product section will go there, okay? And below there is a total amount to pay. If you want to change it somehow, you can do it here. And if you want to write any discount, you can do it there. And if I write a discount, I need to click anywhere else, any other field, and the discount will be applied, okay? So this is how it basically works. And also, please remember that if some of these people will have a discount associated with them, as I shown you before, you can edit a person, and you can write her a discount here and associate it with the given dates, and this discount will be automatically written here. So right now there won't be any discount. I just write it here and click here. And okay, so let me just make the total back again because I messed it up. All right, so if your customer wants to write to pay you in advance, what you do is you simply write an advance amount here. For example, they paid 100 euro. And below it, you will see the dynamically assigned reservation statuses. These reservation statuses are picked from here. So if you see one, two, or three options here, this means that these are the only logical options for now. And let's see. We have an advance paid. This is a future reservation. So it all fits perfectly. If I leave it to zero, I don't have an advance paid, but I can either have my reservation scheduled or confirmed. It depends on your reservation policy. Do you confirm reservation if no advance is paid or not, okay? So in my case, the customer will make a full payment already. And as you can see, the only logical option is reservation paid full, okay? Fully paid, sorry. And about these two options, we also have guaranteed by credit card option. It doesn't really go anywhere, if you so to say. If you select it, it's just an information for you that customer has given you somewhere else outside of KW Hotel. He has given you his credit card data, and you have guaranteed this reservation by the credit card, okay? And local tax, if you have some resort by the sea, you might be losing local tax. At least in Poland, it is very, very popular. And if you have something like local tax, you can click here, and whatever you have configured in the tax section of KW Hotel will be added here, okay? And the advanced due date, it doesn't really apply to the free version so much, but if you select this option here, if no advance is paid by that day, the reservation will be marked as customer hasn't arrived. So sorry, it is applicable to the free version as well. And okay, that's all we need to know for the first part of the tutorial. And in a moment, we will discuss the remaining fields and I'll explain what else can it bring to you to make your reservation management more efficient and simply bring you more revenue. Okay, so see you there.